हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू आवर चैनल मेडिको स्टिक फॉल इन लव विद मेडिसिन। सो टुडे इज आवर टॉपिक इज एनाटॉमी ऑफ स्कैपुला पार्ट टू। सो टुडे वी विल कवर द फर्स्ट इज लिगामेंट ऑफ स्कैपुला स्कैपुला, सेकेंड मसल्स of scapula, quick revision or you can say important points of scapula, and the last is MCQ. okay, before starting this topic I will tell you the MCQs that are last time we I have given in the anatomy of scapula part 1. So here are the answers of the scapula. So the first answer is B. Second is D. And third is A, which is 2 to 7, superior border and shoulder girdle. Yes, the another name of the scapula is shoulder girdle. The superior border is the smallest and thinnest, or you can say shortest border, because it lies on the upper side of the scapula, and from 2 to 7 is the answers where the scapula is located. Okay, so now we will start with the today's topic. The first is we will talk about the ligaments. Okay, so ligaments, so the first ligament is acromioclavicular ligament. Ligament acromioclavicular, if we split this ligament into two parts, acromion and clavicular. So acromion is the another part of scapula. Scapula contain two processes, acromion and coracoid process. So one is acromion and clavicular is the another Latin name of clavicle. So this ligament joins between scapula and clavicle at the acromioclavicular. Okay, so here I will draw a small diagram, so you will easily get to know where these ligaments are located. So this is scapula, like this, okay, and this is coracoid process, and here you will see that this is acromion process. The thickest, the smallest one is coracoid and the bigger one is acromion. If you didn't see our last video on anatomy of scapula, then please go to our first part of the scapula, so you will easily get to know which process is there in scapula. Now this is clavicle. Okay, between acromion, here is our acromion, let me write the name, acromion process of scapula. What is this? Scapula, and this is clavicle. So between these two we will find out the ligament, which is known as ligament acromioclavicular. Okay, now the second ligament is ligament coracoclavicular. This ligament is actually splits into two parts, right? The first is ligament trapezoidium, and the second is ligament conoidium. So ligament trapezoidium is found from coracoid process to the clavicle. Here in clavicle, we have a line which is known as trapezoid line, at that this ligament is joined. That's why this ligament is known as trapezoidium ligament. Okay, because here in clavicle we have the trapezoid line. Now the second is conoidium ligament. This ligament is from the base of the coracoid process towards the conoid tubercle, which is also found in the clavicle. It's like this. This ligament joins like this. Okay, so the upper one is ligament trapezoidium, and this one is ligament conoidium. Here I will write that trapezoid ligament starts from the origin, you can say origin, from the base of coracoid process and inverted into trapezoid line of clavicle. Okay, and conoid process originate from base of coracoid process. This both starts from the coracoid process at the base and inverted into conoid tubercle of clavicle. Okay, so this is origin and insertion of these three ligaments. Now the third ligament of scapula is known as ligament coracoacromion. By the name, you can split into two parts, coracoid process and acromion process, right? This ligament is actually found between scapula only. Like here, you know, this is coracoid process and this is acromion process. So this ligament joins this scapula only. There is a no inversion of the clavicle. Okay, by the name you can easily know that. So it's origin and its insertion. Okay, now the fourth ligament. There are actually five ligaments in the scapula. So this one is fourth ligament, which is known as ligament transversum scapulae superioris. Okay, by the name you will get to know that this ligament must be on the transverse side of the scapula, but on the superior margin. Yes, so this ligament is actually found between the notch. Here we have the superior notch. So here this ligament is found. Okay, now the last ligament, the fourth ligament, is not fifth ligament, last ligament, ligament transversum scapulae inferior. If there is superior, then inferior must be, it must be there. Okay, so this ligament is actually from the root of the acromion. So I will write the origin. Origin is from the root of the acromion. Then it goes to the downwards to the neck of scapula. And finally inverted into lateral surface of glenoid cavity. As you know that this part is known as glenoid cavity, right? So this ligament starts from the root of acromion, from here goes to the neck, to the lateral part of the glenoid cavity, right? Like this. So the most important one thing that I forget to tell you, that the strongest ligament in the scapula is this ligament. This ligament is the strongest ligament. Ligament coracoacromialis. So these are the ligaments of the scapula. So there are 5 ligaments: acromioclavicular, coracoclavicular, coracoacromialis, the transverse scapulae superior, transverse scapulae inferior. So these are the ligaments of the scapula. Now we will talk about the muscles of the scapula. Muscles of scapula. There are actually 6 muscles in the scapula. Yes. So let's begin with the first muscle, which is known as musculus deltoideus. Yes, in Latin name, the muscle is known as musculus. So musculus deltoideus. So it originates from clavicle and scapulae. Actually, in scapula, lower border of spine, which is also known as infraspinatus, and inverted into deltoid tubercle of humerus. Okay, so humerus have the deltoid tubercle. This we will show in the humerus, where this tubercle is found. It is inserted in the humerus. So here I will draw a diagram. Here we have the clavicle. So from here, like this, we have this one is acromion process. This is scapula only, okay, like this. And from here we have the humerus, and this is glenoid process, right? So this is clavicle, this is scapula, and this one is humerus, okay. So this ligament found like this, it actually covers the whole shoulder joint. Shoulder joint. Okay. Now we will talk about the second ligament, which is known as musculus supraspinatus. As by name, you can see this supraspinatus on the upper side of the spine, right? So its origin from supraspinous fossa, or you can say the upper surface of spine, and spine, and inverted in greater tubercle of humerus. Okay, so this spine found from supraspinatus, upper surface of the spine, to the greater tubercle of the humerus. It is like this on the back side. Okay, now the third muscle is musculus infraspinatus. As by name, you can say that from infraspinous fossa, or you can say inferior surface of spine, to greater tubercle of humerus. Same, they have similar in insertion, inversion. So this one will found like here we have spine. Okay, so from superior part there will be supraspinatus, and from inferior part it will go like this. Let me draw this color. You can distinguish it to the greater tubercle of the humerus. Now we have, so the fourth one is musculus teres minor. Okay, this musculus origin from lateral border of scapula of infraspinatus fascia. Infraspinous fascia and inverted to greater tubercle of humerus. So here I draw a diagram. This is our scapula. It's a posterior part of the scapula. Okay, so posterior part will be look like this, and this we have the spinous. And from here the clavicle will be there, and here what we have, humerus. Okay, this is greater tubercle, okay, of humerus. So this muscle will go like this from here to greater tubercle. Okay, this one will be the greater tubercle, musculus minor teres. Okay, now the fifth muscle is known as musculus teres major. This one is major. Okay, its origin from same area that we have in minor. Okay, lateral border of scapula, but the inversion is different. Yes, it is crest of lesser tubercle of humerus. So this one is lesser tubercle, here tubercle of humerus. So this muscle will be like this, it joins like this. Okay, so how these two muscles are joined each other. Now the last and final muscle and today's last part of the lecture, this is musculus subscapularis. Okay, its origin from costal surface, which is anterior surface. Yes, costal surface of scapulae, or you can say subscapular fossa, because on the costal surface we have the this fossa, and insertion to lesser tubercle of humerus. The difference in these three are that this found on the posterior surface of scapula, right, but this one will found on the anterior surface of the scapula. So here we have this humerus, okay, and this is our clavicle, clinoid process and clavicle. So this muscle found like this to the lesser, like this. So this is how these muscles are joined to the humerus, and you can say that the muscles of the scapula. Now this is time for the MCQs. So these are the today's MCQs. So होप यू विल आंसर ऑन द कॉमेंट सेक्शन एंड यू विल गेट आंसर इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो ऑफ द मेडिको स्टिक. होप यू लाइक दिस वीडियो. इफ यू लाइक दिस वीडियो देन हिट द लाइक बटन. इफ यू आर न्यू टू दिस चैनल देन प्लीज सब्सक्राइब अवर चैनल. प्रेस द बेल आइकन एंड शेयर अवर वीडियो एज मच एज यू कैन. वी आर रीडिंग योर ऑल कॉमेंट्स. थैंक यू फॉर गिविंग अस सपोर्ट. थैंक यू.